YouTube. I'm back with another tutorial for paint.net. This time we're going to be looking at layers. Now I think I said that it was going to be towards the end of the series and stuff like that, but I decided, you know, it's probably best that I teach you guys this first before you move on to learning all the effects and stuff like that. It is one of the more handy things that you can actually use in this program. So I'm just going to clean up my workspace a little bit. I'm just going to move these over here for the time being, because that's how I usually work with paint.net, is having it all over on this side. Anyhow, so we have this picture of spawn that I took at for my server that I'm working on. This is actually a new biome that I was working with, World Edit. Anyhow, now layers, this is the layers window. You're going to be working with this window quite a bit. Now to create a new layer, you just click the add new layer thing way at the left hand side, and it'll add a blank thing. Now you don't actually see it because it's transparent. So if we do this, obviously it looks like I drew on the image, but if I bring it that layer and drag it right under, it disappears. So you can literally edit the image without actually removing any of the content. It's good if you need to make a mistake, or if you made, like, doing detail works and you ended up doing a mistake or something like that. You can always just fix it within the layer and not need to worry about erasing the actual image or the background image or anything like that. A few examples, I've pulled up some interesting images. I have a picture of a plane. We're just going to drop that into here. Now we have a plane, right? So now it's on top, and any layers, anything on the top layer is going to be the first thing shown. Anything at the bottom is going to be the last thing shown. So if we move the plane down, it's not going to be shown. If we move it up, then it's above the background or anything below it. So next we're going to copy the clouds that I originally worked on. So now, because the clouds are behind the plane, it's not actually in front of the plane. So I kind of want the mist effect. I'm going to bring it in like that, so it kind of gives it some misty kind of feel to it, but you can still see the plane a little bit. And we're going to create another layer because we're adding some text, because this is going to be like a movie type thing. And Minecraft at War. So now we have some text to work with. Now we could basically just select the text and leave it at that, or we could do something even more fun with it. So I'm just going to select the background because it's easier to select the thing, and then hit Control I, and then that selects the entire font. And I'm going to create a new layer because I don't want to mess up the font. I don't want to type it again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose some appropriate colors. Use our color picker. And I'm going to zoom in on those leaves because why not? We'll get some color from the leaves. We'll use that color and that. Oop. Because we're not on that layer, we have to go to the actual background layer, or the layer that you're getting your colors from. So that and that. Okay, now we go back to the layer that we were working on, and I'm gonna go and grab a gradient color. Just kind of go like this, maybe a little bit. You know what, I think that green needs to be a little bit lighter, so I'm gonna bring that up and bring that down. So I don't think that blends in too well. So what I'm going to end up doing is I'm going to outline. Now we're going to get into all this stuff in a future video, really soon video actually. We have the adjustments and effects. So a lot of these are plugins, so I'm going to cover that in a separate tutorial. But I'm going to outline the thing. 255. So now that looks pretty decent. Got some stuff, but you know what? I'm not entirely finished yet. I think a nice backdrop for a shadow would be really nice on here too. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to one of our plugins that we installed in the previous video, and I'm going to add a shadow backdrop. I'm going to bring that up to 10 and bring that up to 10 and say 5. That's what I usually do for my videos. And click OK. So now you kind of get the idea what all this kind of builds into, right? So, I mean, we could do the same thing for the plane. Just go back up here and do effect. And there you go. Now the plane's sticking out. We could do the clouds, but because it's transparent, it's not the best thing to do because it does that and it doesn't really look realistic. So we just leave it at that. I mean, you can test things out and play around with it, but overall, that's what basically layers are. You can work within layers to create your overall kind of work. your work to make it a little more easier, and also it gives it more character. The more layers you use, you can go as many layers as you use, but the more layers you use, the better quality. Like it's gonna basically save your butt from messing up and having to undo a whole selection. I mean, I would usually generally just have a layer for a certain specific thing, not a group of things normally, because it if you have a bunch of group of things on one layer, then it gets a little hard to move places and stuff like that. Especially if they're side by side like the font is. So if I move that, then the selection kind of distorts the war part and stuff like that. I'll show you that right now actually. So say I have this at and I want it more over towards here. As you can see, it kind of, the selection starts erasing the other stuff. So, but if it was on its own layer, it wouldn't do that, as you can see. So, I mean, I hope that's easy to understand as far, like, definitely use layers as much as you can. And now, if you were to save this right now, it would save it as a paint.net file. So unless you compress all these layers using the merge layer down thing where the little blue arrow is going down, but it's the tiny little blue arrow, and make sure you're selected on the top layer to merge it down. And once you get back to your background or whatever image thing that you have, then you can go to file, save as, and save it as anything you want, and it will save as the file format you want. Now, if you saved it previously as a paint.net file, then you're going to have to go to File, Save As, and then select PNG, JPEG, or anything else, because most likely the default will be the paint.net file. It's just how it's programmed. It's a little bit different. But I hope you found this video helpful. If you're new, please subscribe. I do a bunch of tutorials and stuff on this channel. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. There's some more videos right on the screen right now that you can click. I'll see you guys next time.
We'll be right back.